Hey, the future of people, empty of knowledge. We believe and know that life is a gift from God, and our gift for God should be the way we live our life. No one can add one day more to his life. We can choose how we live every day, our actions and the people around us. Ugly truth, you will never make money if you have nothing to give. You have to give a part of yourself. On the other side, we choose how we live our life, being constrained, limited, living in restriction or forced by the life facts we were born, the family and city where we live, poor or rich with the responsibilities we must have having wealth or being poor. We live having the our life goal every day as motivation factor to wake up. Never give up, never give everything. Never give up giving. We are constrained to live one type of life that is hard, because we must work for money, and not anyone is working what they love, but rather what they find to work. In this Ugly Truth Talk episode, from Ugly Truth Man, we will talk about knowledge emptiness in life, what can we give and receive for free. The first empty part of our life, is in the body and mind and is the meaning, the sense of our life here on earth. More than 80% life just lived by regular habits, same activities, no purpose, no meaning, no questions in life and about life. Daily carousel of activities, work, home, work, shopping, work, and weekend. A limited mindset, living with the money they earn and complain about everything, even about the color of the sky, if one morning it is gray. Isn't gray also a beautiful color? The empty part of life is fulfilled with drinks, parties, smoke, and hangover mornings, makeup. Fake outside, empty inside, people running towards dopamine and other chemicals and having weekly activities that make you and them depend on those activities. Activities that suck your energy, time, and value as a human being. The second type of emptiness is the knowledge. The next generations have less knowledge and education, and we will talk about a few examples. For many people, it is too late to learn. What we didn't learn when we were young or when we had time, we will never learn. Today, just regretting and complain about the past, is sad and combined with present laziness. This is one reason why young people don't work any job. They have preferences instead of learning everything, because you never know in life when a past experience can be useful in the future. Other category people have stopped learning at a certain moment in the past, and they are stuck at that level of knowledge in the past, but everything and in any year everything is updating, new things are discovered and improved. Other people have learned things that didn't help them in life, and the last category of people, poor people, is the people who don't know nothing, zero skills, zero knowledge, and they wait for someone to offer them a working place and a salary, and to learn to work there, and every time they change job, they learn new skills. Other people have too much knowledge and cannot adapt between people, or choose in life what to do. Some are creating businesses. Knowledge means facts, information, and skills acquired through experience or education, the theoretical or practical understanding of a subject. The future of knowledge in life is about self-education. You learn for yourself what you love or what you want to do in life. You learn at home. You take some exams to receive a diploma. Another fact is you choose what you learn. In life you will not need mathematics if you want to be a writer, or chemistry if you want to be a painter. The truth of life is that you will learn continuously, we will learn until our last day of living, we must adapt, we must be focused in the present and prepare for the future, think for yourself, not just swallow information, or other people's thoughts and opinions. I know people, young and not so old anymore, they wasted precious years of their life with games, sleeping 12 hours per day, partying and on social media sites, and now the piggy bank of time getting smaller. You cannot and will never make money if you have nothing to give. An example of life: I want to help someone, I have a small salary, I work hard for those money, for me is difficult to give cash money, I can offer one day of my life working and helping that person, or I can give some jars of honey, the only product I am selling right now. Words can't extinguish hunger or a need. I can give some food or something to wear. The free things anyone can give and have them, it is a start in building a relationship between people. You can give a smile, a helping hand, a piece of your time, an idea, a solution to a problem. You can give your trust, keep a secret. You can listen or give an idea, courage, importance, share, and teach a skill that you have, exchange some information. You can embrace or give a hug. You can say thank you. You can cry and laugh with someone. In the book of Romans chapter 12, in Bible is written, "Be happy with those who are happy, and weep with those who weep." I didn't know I am so rich. The books are free, information is free, but you must do your part, listen, learn and practice. Investing in knowledge is an investment for the future. How to survive in hard times, in times of crisis, how to live with less or in stressful situations. Knowledge about food and eating, knowledge about basic health, life laws, and money laws. Knowledge about people, emotions and love facts. Rich are not those who have many things. Rich are those who can be happy with a few things. The rest of things are called wealth, blessings, responsibilities, and helping others, changing lives and communities. Never give up. Never give everything. Never give up giving. If you want success, you have to give, to inspire, to offer a part of you, of yourself. Ugly Truth Man salutes you.